I'm Professor Robin Tanamachi. I'm an assistant professor of atmospheric science here in the Department of Earth, Atmospheric, and Planetary Sciences at Purdue. We have an atmospheric science department with lots of students who are very excited about severe storms. We decided to create a course that would allow them to go out in the field, witness severe storms, and also get their hands on some research-grade instrumentation to record observations in the storms, and Skylar is a welcome part of that.
I'm Allison LaFleur, and I am a graduate student here at Purdue.
I'm Milind Sharma. I'm a PhD student with Dr. Robin Tanamachi at Purdue University.
I work with Robin to look at radar data and then to ultimately analyze it and analyze the storms.
So I was part of a research team wherein we were working on an NSF-funded project. This was a collaborative project with the University of Massachusetts, and I was in there in a radar truck with another grad student from UMass, and we were chasing storms all over the southern and central plains in USA.
I've had a long-standing professional relationship with Dr. Steve Fraser at the University of Massachusetts. So when I heard that he had a portable phased array radar that was dual polarized, I got really excited. I said, if we can put that on a truck and actually take it out in the field and get it in front of some tornadic supercells, that would be an enormous advance over what we've been doing thus far.
Stephen Fraser, I'm a professor in the Electrical and Computer Engineering Department. We are affiliated with the CASA Research Center, which stands for the Center for Collaborative Adaptive Sensing of the Atmosphere. And through that project, we've been collaborating with Raytheon for some time. We're not meteorologists, but we sort of have to straddle that boundary between engineering and meteorology.
My name is William Heberling. I'm in my fifth year of PhD work here at Mercer Labs. So I was one of the primary drivers for getting the radar where it needs to go, driving. But I was also responsible for setting up and taking down the radar, as well as operating it while we're collecting data.
Casey Wolfe, master's graduate student, UMass Amherst. I basically set up the generator, turn it on, get the computer up and running, raise up the radar, get it pointed to where you want.
Getting to work in this lab and have the opportunity to have access to a radar like that is really a unique experience.